Joseph was a young man, and yet he lived holy. David was a young man, yet he lived a holy life. Daniel was a young man, yet he lived a holy life. And Samuel was a young man, yet he lived a holy life. Whoever maintained the relationship with God as a young person, look at their future. Look at how God blessed them. Joseph, because he was holy as a young person, God blessed him to be the prime minister of Egypt. Look at Samuel. Because he lived a holy life as a young man, God made him a prophet, a priest, a great judge. Look at Daniel. As a young man, he never allowed the practices of Babylon to disturb him and to defile him. He was holy. And as a result of his holiness, he became next to king. Same thing with David. David was holy as a young man. The Bible says that God found a man after his own heart. And because God found a young man, holy and righteous, God chose him to be the king of Israel. The Bible says the eyes of God searching back and forth throughout the world to find a faithful person so that he can strengthen him and bless him. Is there any occasion, is there any time that God's eyes fell on you? Looking at you, looking at your righteousness, looking at your holiness, looking at your faithfulness. Did God could find you to be that young man, young woman, trying to please God, trying to live a holy life? When God searched the world, he found Joseph, he found David, he found Daniel, he found Samuel. They were young people and yet they were holy. God is in search of young people, those who live in holiness. If God is searching now in our group, in our midst, if God is searching each one of us, how many of you can be proved, can be found as holy? And how many of us God can choose us and select us and elect us, saying that I need you because I see you undefiled. I see you as a holy young man and young woman. I see you that you always live a separate life, a sanctified life. You are spiritual. You are committed. You have the character that pleases me. Can God say, looking at you, but dear brother, sister, if not, how are we living and where are we living? Just let us examine ourselves.